this word, I don't want to have you up and down too much. Chapter 12. Pastor said, everything is good in your life. And it came to pass on the seventh day that the child died, and the servants of David feared to tell him that the child was dead. For they said, behold, while the child was yet alive, we spake unto him, and he would not hearken unto our voice. How will he then vex himself if we tell him that the child is dead? Take your seats in God's presence. I want to put you in your heart from the subject of how to have a bad day.
All right.
How to handle a bad day. I said one more time. How to handle a bad day. Like yourself. Thank you, Pastor, for that being your motto. Good to be alive. That life brings about some amazing. It brings blessings. It brings cheer. It brings dynamics. It brings excitement. There's fun in life. There's happiness. There's gladness. There's some joy. There's some infusion. There's some merriment. There's some noise. There are parties involved. There are some resolves in life. There are some place in life. There are some terrificness. Life is full of zeal and zest, but there are some times in our life when it's not so good. I want to believe that I'm not the only one who had his fair share of hardships, his fair share of hard times when we're dealing with this life. Although life will be bad sometimes, that we got to figure out a way to get through our bad days. These series of tests that's got to take. And he went through the regimen of that, and he went on home, and in a week later, he said somebody knocked on his door.
All right.
Came to the door, he looked out, answered the door, asked, are he, they asked for him. And so and so here, he said yes. And the lady said, can I come in? He told this man, well, how can I help you? She told him, he went to a jail last week. And he said, yes, man, I paid my fine, got my license and everything, so how can I help you? She said, no, I really came to tell you. So not some good news. He said, when you took the test and stuff, I'm sad to inform you that you was HIV positive. Like any normal person, he went to his own doctor, took the test, found out, much to his surprise, he was HIV positive. And I simply share this to tell you that sometimes, you and I can have a bad thing. Or take your lady who's never been with a man sexually. She's only 15. And the young guy, 2 doors down from her, had befriended her. And he pressed her, and told her, we're going to get married. And she finally yielded to his request, only to lay down with her, only to find out when she got up, 3 weeks later, that she was pregnant. And I said to tell you that sometimes we have a bad day. And his mother told him, no, you got it, so now you don't spend no time with me. You always bring it around, you always running, going. Listen, won't we do like we used to do? Won't we call it a way and have a red box night? Won't you you pick a movie, we sit out, pop some popcorn, and watch movies
that's
like
that. Right. That's
all right.
Young man said, sound good. He said, I don't want me some water, I'm going to take my bath first. And while she was in the tub, somebody knocked on the door. It was friendly. He told me, look, I got two tickets to the bridge game. They had court. You got to go with me. He told me, I promise mom, I'm going to watch the movie tonight. I can't go with this. These seats right behind the players. They're your favorite team in town. You get a chance to touch him if you want to. Come on to the game. I promise we're going to go to the game, watch the game, we'll come right back to the house.
All right.
He did it. So by the time his mom came out, he would put his shoes on. She said, where you going, son? I thought you were going to watch the game. But he said, well, yes, man. Come on, man. I ain't telling you to come all the time. I got it. I promise we're going. We ain't going to do nothing else but watch the game. We're coming right back. Went to the game, enjoyed himself. Greeted the beat man away. Never left. After the game, shots went down. When smoke cleared the dust out, I had a young man lying in bed. Gunshot wound to the head. And I said, sure, that's your intent. But sometimes we have bad days.
All right.
They had a bad day. That day, the right caravan I text, but he had a bad day. One day, it started back in chapter 11. He stood out on his balcony. And here's the thing about David having a bad day. First of all, he should have been in war. And because the text says 11:1, it was a time when kings were off the war. But David was at home. His own holiday. And he stepped out on the ground and saw somebody else's wife. Told his men, look, I want you to go down to Sackville, send her, tell her king's niece to send her.
All right.
She, obedient to what the king said, she came on David Lively. She went back home, only to discover she was with child.
All right.
She was with child. So David, his mind is working now. He's trying to figure out a way that he can cover this stuff up.
That's right.
Because this is going to be bad. I mean, the king had did something like this. Yeah, I got to cover this up so he sees it. Said, well, Hood, told Hood, come on back, King needs to see you. Hood came back, he had a scrumptious meal, or a glass of wine, and told Hood, how they doing in the war? He said, the Hood told him, Uriah said, look, the war's going well, don't seem like long, we'll be overtaking them, we'll win this war. They said, well, sound good, why don't you go home and spend this time with your wife?
All right.
Uriah, and his faithfulness, wouldn't go home. You all the way home. The king is giving you a prayer. Won't you go on and be with your wife? She won't she miss you too. Only discovered the next morning that Uriah was sleeping on the porch. So David had to come up with something else. He wouldn't go. And I think about this on DJ and look at your body right back. Uriah's faithfulness. How many folks will be faithful like that? How many of us will pass up an opportunity? Pass up an opportunity to get out some hard work. To go home and be with your wife. Your husband. But anyway, Uriah, he didn't do it. So David said, I know what I tell you what we'll do. He wrote it out. He told Joab, put Uriah on the front line and look for the troops. Allow him to be killed in battle. Then he gave him the left. Talk about faithfulness. Gave him the left. Told him, give it to Joab when we get back on the battlefield. How many of us? Can't you see yourself not holding that up to the light? Look for one another. The letter won't look like it's been opened to see what the king has to say. He didn't do nothing. He gave the letter. They did what he did. He should be right. After time of mourning, they took her to be his wife. Only to discover, remember, she's with the child. And now David is praying. Now she real sick. With the child, she. You gotta understand that there will be consequences. For the sin that you and I commit, there will be consequences. That will lead to us having a bad day. And they pray and saw God's face. That the child would make it safe. That the child would enter into this world a healthy baby boy, a healthy baby girl. He prayed, he sought the Lord, he fasted, but still, here it is. The child died. It is a text. We have a text right now. It said, and it came to pass. On the seventh day, that the child died. Yeah. The child died. It was a bad day for King David. A bad day for Bathsheba. It was a bad day. How to handle it? Bad day. We're going to take real closely. Here's several things that we got to do in order for us to handle a bad day. The text says, verse 19 says, but when David saw that his servants whispered, first thing you got to do. When you're having a bad day, you got to dismiss the opinion of other folks. You got to tune folks out when you have a bad day. Because folks are following your bad day, you listen to what they have to say. Text said he saw the servants whispering. And you and I got some folks around us now still talking about some stuff. Yeah. Still talking about why we did what we did. What we did what we did. But they don't really have an answer to what we're doing because you look at their life closely, they're doing bad. You got to dismiss what folks also sing. And all of them can talk. Hey, listen, I come to discover the short years I've been here that no matter what we do, folk gonna talk.
All right.
Yeah. It don't matter what you do, folk gonna have something to say. Yeah. If you ain't working, you're too fat, if you lose weight, you're too skinny, if you cut your hair, you're rebellious, if you grow your hair, you're a hippie, if you wear your clothes tight, you're a sissy, if you wear them loose, you're a thug. I'm moving forward. I ain't gonna get stuck there. I'm not gonna situation. But they, the text says now that they washed and anointed himself in changes of her. Took off this stuff. That was yesterday. You know, it hurt. But I'm moving forward.